So when I first came to Syracuse, I was elected in the very first election of Student Association to serve as an assembly representative, and it didn't take me long to gain some presidential ambitions, but I wanted to kind of get a feel for what it was like to be a woman leader on this campus, so I started asking other members, when was the last time we had a woman serve as president? And I came to find out that there was one several years before I came to campus, but overall, in a near 60-year history, there were very few altogether. So, of course, I started doing a lot of work, getting really involved, and before I knew it, I became vice president my sophomore year. Vice president was great. I had a fantastic time doing it, but there was a student who made a comment saying, well, you're a great sidekick. That's how women are. And I took serious offense to that, to think that women were just meant to be VP and not meant to be president. So, of course, when I ran for president, that was an entirely different story. I had an amazing experience, and there were definitely hard times. I remember dealing with various bouts of sexism and gender discrimination during that time, and it was difficult, but I knew that that was part of the battle. But also, while I was running for president, I was in a class called Rationality in Politics, and I had to put together a research project on some kind of puzzle that I saw in politics. So, of course, I went with why so few women in college campuses across the country are not pursuing the presidency. And it's not that women are not even winning, it's just that they're not running in the first place. And of course, this is attributed to a lot of different things. Sexism, women feeling that they're not as ready to run as men are. And of course, the fact that a lot of men make student government out to be a good old boys club. And I wanted to change that. So during my research, I found out about Elect Her and the work that Running Start and the American Association of University Women does on all of these different college campuses, and I knew that we needed to have Elect Her come to campus. So it was very exciting when I finally got the news that we were selected as a training site, and I know that this is the change that we need to have here on campus. We're in a critical moment in university history where we have a lot of women who are pursuing leadership. We had Chancellor Kanner, who is such a fantastic piece of our history here, and we also have the Women's Leadership Initiative, which has done great things for getting women at the table and talking about issues women face, not just from men, not just from the media, but issues that they face together and face from each other. So I know that bringing all these issues to the table now during our Empowered Women's Week is going to be just what we need, and it's amazing to see the diversity of women who are involved. It's not just women who want to pursue politics, but women who are pursuing STEM fields or women who want to change the film industry. And knowing that we're empowering a lot of women to lead and equipping them with those skills, that is so rewarding, and I'm so excited to see what Elect Her holds.